So it's sort of a free-for-all, but I thought I would try to begin by persuading you of one proposition, which is that the presidential election should matter hardly at all to anyone in this room. And there are several reasons for this. First of all, months ago, I thought that there was very slim chance the Republicans would ever take out Obama. And I have seen nothing to change my mind on that point. I just don't think it's going to happen. Especially because by the time Romney gets the nomination, he's going to be so bloody, such a bloody carcass. I just don't think he's going to be able to do anything. And I don't know if you noticed this, but the Republicans are very, very good at giving the opposition great scare quotes against themselves, which all of them have been doing. Romney, his aren't as publicized because the other ones are even crazier, but they will get to Romney in due course. So that's the first reason. The next simple reason is just that Romney? Wow, how much of my resources do I actually want to spend getting somebody like Romney in the White House? The father of Obamacare, wonderful. But then the other reason is simply that there is simply nothing that realistically that anyone in this room can do that's going to make any difference in the outcome of the presidential election. You could work from now until election day, 60 hours a week, doing nothing but promoting your candidate of choice, and you know how much difference it would make? Goose egg. None. No difference. So, yes. It shouldn't really matter to you. I mean, it's easy to get emotionally invested in the high-profile races, but honestly, that's just not it. It's not even hardly worth worrying about. Though, for the record, I do have my preference already picked, so it's worth a slight amount of thought. So what should you do instead? I think that we've already covered this ground, but I'm just going to review it because I think it's worth reviewing. First thing, if you really want to do on-the-ground politics, you can pick a local candidate for Congress or even Senate, not in Colorado, but elsewhere, such as Stephen Bailey when he was in CD2. I was out patiently walking through my neighborhood handing out Stephen Bailey flyers. And that is worth doing. And at that level, you can actually make some kind of difference and have a real interaction with real voters about your candidate of choice. Or pick a state house race. I shouldn't have looked this up. What fraction of people in Congress were once in their state legislatures? My guess is it's the large majority, right? That's how they work themselves up through the system. If you want to change Congress, change your state legislature. There are some really good state legislators here in the Colorado legislature, and I'm sure that that's true, probably for most of you, depending on where you live. So that's an extremely effective place to put your resources if you want to do on the ground politics, because there's a limited number of voters. You can actually go and meet a large percentage of the voters and have real conversations, ideological conversations, revolving your candidate of choice. So that is a much better use of your time. It's maybe more work up front to do the research, but picking the good state rep. And it doesn't even necessarily have to be in your area, right? You can work for state reps or candidates for Congress outside of your area. For instance, FreedomWorks has this system set up where you can make phone calls and such on behalf of people running for Congress elsewhere in the country. But of course, you don't have to do on-the-ground electoral politics. Or you can also do ballot measures, because here in Colorado, if you're wanting, there's more than half the states have ballot measures, right? So here in Colorado, we already know that we're very lucky to have the personhood for round three. And so if you have something like that in your state, or I'm sure there will be other economic matters in the state, there will be other things elsewhere. So pick one of those and work on it, especially because it is more ideological in nature. Okay, so but if you're not interested in any of that, simply forget the election altogether and do something ideological. Last night, Brad pointed out again that one of our central problems here, and something that nobody on our team is addressing, is the lack of freedom in education and the widespread propaganda in the quote public school system. So, and yet to my knowledge, there is no objectivist who takes this issue seriously as sort of their core activist issue. Somebody like Andrew Bernstein has done a lot of good work on the issue, but this is one of many of his assortment of issues, which is great for him, right? So there's lots of other possibilities. So ultimately, it doesn't really, the presidential race, I mean, the outcome does matter, but what we do about it just frankly doesn't matter.